All right, third video in the series Advanced C. This time I want to explain what a void pointer is and why it's useful. So to understand what a void pointer is, you have to understand what a pointer is, which I guess you know, but maybe a small refresher. So a pointer is just contains just an address to something in memory. And so the pointer itself is just an unsigned integer, is what you have to understand. And like the so if you if you do int a pointer to something, actually like the pointer is not of type int. It's like the data that is pointed by the pointer is an int or an array of integers. So the type that you associate with a pointer is only used when it's dereferenced. And the point is that sometimes if you make a library or something that needs to be very generic, sometimes you just don't care about the underlying type of the data. Sometimes you can just consider it as a big blob of bytes that you have to process. So if you have a, an example is always better. So if I have an integer a that is equal to 3, and I decide to have a void pointer to the address of a, you can see that it compiles, but I can print the value of that pointer. So we can see that it has some address, which is just, as I said, an unsigned int. But if you try to actually print the, like to dereference it, he doesn't know the type. So he doesn't know if he needs to like use a byte. Like, does he, at this address, is it like 1 byte, 2 bytes? Is it an array that is 10,000 bytes? So since he doesn't know, as you see, it's a compile error. And to have it to make it compile, you have to first convert it to an integer pointer. So here I convert p to an integer pointer, and then I dereference it. So that's a very basic example, but it becomes a lot more useful when you mix it with functions. Because then you can make more generic function. For example, here is a small implementation of the memset function. If you don't know memset, it just takes a void pointer to a destination, so any pointer, and oh, that's memcopy, whatever. Man memset. Man memset, up. So memset will set the memory to like it's an int, but it's treated as a byte. So every single byte at this address will be filled with this byte, and here you pass the length. So actually, it's like the length of the underlying data is passed as a runtime instead of at compile time, and it's a downside of C, I guess, because some languages, like let's say Rust or C++, since you have templating, and sometimes you can know more stuff at compile time, and so you wouldn't need void pointers, and you could optimize potentially stuff a little better. But oops, that's my example stuff. But yeah, so let's run through this example. So we have an array of x. Let's print it like this. Nobody cares. So just an array of integers, and then my memset didn't test it before, so hopefully it's correct. And let's say we want every element that is here to 2, and we just want the size of x. Oh, doesn't work. Uh, Oh, just didn't print it. Oh, yeah, no, okay, it makes sense because it's an array of. I'm confusing myself, but yeah, it's an array of integers, so it has literally all the time like the 4 bytes of the integer are equal to 2, so it creates a large value. But let's say I say 0, it's all 0. That makes a bit more sense. I mean, it's a bit more understandable. And then you can go with an even more complex example. I've created a map function that takes again a void pointer, the size, and this time we consider that this void pointer is an array and it's not enforced at compile time, so you can really like it's a sharp tool to use, but here we consider that it's an array, and then it gives the length of this array, the number of elements in this array, and the size of each element, and then a function to apply to each of those. And you can see I'm casting x's as bytes because it's easier to work with. And then I just loop over each element, and then I do I times size because we need to shift I times, we need to shift by the size of the element. And we pass that address to some function, which happens to be squared. And in the function also takes a void pointer, also needs to convert it, and then it needs to do whatever it wants with it. And the way you would call that is x's, and then the size, the number of element is 5, and then it's the size of each element is of size int, and then the function is square. This, and you can see it has squared every single element. And yeah, that's basically it for void pointers. Quite useful, especially for working with just memory, and you don't really care about the type, or to do some runtime polymorphic type stuff. I don't know, like treating a blob of memory as a different type according that something that happens at the runtime. So yeah, that's it. See you in the next one.